On today's episode, it's the first day of football. Today we are looking at the two quarterbacks, Matthew Stafford and Josh Allen, rookie card prices.
Video is brought to you by Card Lab.
Super Bowl MVP, yeah. So Matthew Stafford, his Topps Chrome Refractor, had a population, definition right here, population, amount of cards. 73 of them. Wow. Over this last 3 months, this card has stayed stable because it has not sold recently. The last sale was August 27th, 2022 for $1,009.99. That card has stayed flat over the last 3 months. Let's look at his PSA 9. So big price difference, 70% haircut. It was $1,000. Now it's $275. It's like a 72% haircut. But if you bought this card 3 months ago, you're up 6%. I mean, eBay fees aren't that hard to predict. But if you were to sell this card for cash and you luckily got in at exactly 260, hopefully a little bit cheaper, and then sold it for 200, the current price, which is 275, you would have made $15. After a 3 month period, 5.77% growth. This is pretty decent. So Matthew Stafford, but the thing I want to show you is, let's look at raw first. So last sold raw refractor was on the 28th of August for $140. But sneaky right here, PSA 8 sold on the 6th, which was just a couple days ago. So 2 days ago, you could have bought a PSA 8, Matthew Stafford, Topps Chrome Refractor, $54, and the PSA 9, and the raw one's going for 140. So that's a pretty something to look at. Just lower grade stuff, high quality cards, buy the card. Matthew Stafford, his stuff over 3 months has not moved down in the lower grade stuff, and very, very slight increases on the higher pop stuff. So like 1% growth or something, 5%, 5.77%. It's so nice. At least it hasn't lost value. I would say 3 out of 4 have gained value over the last 9 days. So that's the Matthew Stafford refractor. That's who's playing tonight for the Los Angeles Rams. We'll see how that goes for Matthew Stafford and his card prices. Josh Allen, this is what concerns me with Josh Allen card prices. It's insane. Top 26, last silver prism, PSA 10. Yes, it has the rainbow effect. If you are new to cards, silver has that rainbow effect. It's not just that bland color. It has that rainbow effect on the card.
Just for example, this is a base card. It's silver in color, yes. But what silver really means is it has this hollow foil effect. Silver means this multicolored rainbow refractor looking effect for the card. This is a rarer card than the base card over here. This has more cards for sure than this one. This one is rarer than this card. Do not pay a premium for this card thinking it is this card. It is not. It has to have this rainbow looking foil on it to make sure it is the silver prism, which is the most desired.
Last one, PSA 10, perfect condition. The best condition, Josh Allen, silver prism card, sold for 10 grand, which is insane. Insane. But I feel like this dude is going to win a lot of games. But I feel like people scooped up his cards raw and are hoarding them. So I would be very cautious of buying this for this price. And over the course of the next 3 to 4 years, the population going up and the price steadily creeping down slowly but surely. So just be aware of that, because I have a prime example. If I had the full data, I'd be able to show you. But for now, I'll show you the market movers data too. So the market movers data shows you the prime example of this card now having a population of 898, which is a pretty decent amount in the card world. Over the last 3 months, it has grown 10%, which 10% is nice over 3 months. In realistic terms, not crazy card world terms, but this card did crash. This card was above 10, same thing as Josh Allen, above $10,000 at the point. So someone bought the dip, and it is now 4,200. So after being 3,850, so that's if you're gone for cash price. And usually, when cards are at that high value, usually you're going to a show and you're going to less on cash. So that Josh or this Patrick Mahomes is a year prior, 2017, which makes me think that this 2018 Josh Allen Silver Prism rookie card has such a low population. Because grading was shut down, people bought all his stuff raw and have it stashed. So over the course of this year, when he lights it up, they go 12 and what's the new thing? 17, 12 and 5, 12 and 4. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this card will creep up the numbers of the population. We'll look back at this video. Today is September 8th, 2022, we'll look back at this video with this card having a population of 26. And in 3-4 years, this card having a population of over 898 of Patrick Mahomes, then I just feel like that this card will end up going up just a tiny bit and then going down ever so steadily. Unless he wins the Super Bowl, then this card, we'll see. The card market doesn't seem dead. All the cards are popping from what I've seen online. But I just feel like this card might have a it's already had a cataclysmic run up, but it might have a cataclysmic, not a cataclysmic, but a steady decline. As long as he doesn't hurt, it was crazy. So, never know. But that's Josh Allen of the Buffalo Bills. So that's who's playing tonight, Matthew Stafford and Josh Allen. I just want to show you a couple other things to relate to them. First, we'll talk with Josh Allen. So we're just talking about his Silver Prism card. Josh Allen's stats over the last 4 years. First year, 2 years, he had under a 60% completion percentage. Both years, barely scraping by with over 3,000 yards in 2019. 20 touchdowns, 9 interceptions, with 85 QBR and a 67.9 QBR in his first 2 years, which would average out to like 75-ish QBR, which they stuck with him. And his 3rd year, breakout year, when he had a completion percentage of nearly 70%, 69.2. If it was 0.3 more, they would have been rounded up, or we could have thought of it being rounded up to 70%. So yards, 4,500 yards, 37 touchdowns, with 10 interceptions, but QBR of 107.2. This last year was a down year compared to this last, but the reason why I think that is because when you have a breakout year, usually teams have more tape on you that make you more challenged, but this guy seems like he's up for the challenge, you know what I mean? So that's why I feel like we're so enthusiastic about his cards and why people are chasing low number parallels, autographs, and other things of the sort. So even though his stats went down a couple percentages, his numbers are still there. The completion percentage is down, but the yards are still there. 44.07 with 36 touchdowns, 15 interceptions, tiny bit more interceptions, but the QBR rating from 92.2. So that is Josh Allen. You will see he is a local from Fireball, from the local valley. So we'll see how he does tonight. Rooting for him. Matthew Stafford, just to go back to the top really fast, has a population of PSA 9 of 136 and a PSA 10 population of 73. Again, to reiterate what population means the amount of cards that are available in the world. So how many are just following the field? So Matthew Stafford, his first year on the Rams, he won the Super Bowl. He had a completion percentage of 67.2, nearly 5,000 cards. Yeah, 5,000. Insane. It's insane, bro. 48-86, 41 TD, 17 interceptions. So what if he's through 17 interceptions? Man, threw 41 touchdowns, bro. The last time that he did that was his 3rd year in the year in the league where he did break 5,000 yards, which that's pretty nuts. That's pretty nuts. But he's also, I have a couple other people's stats pulled up. The reason why I did this is because over the last 2014 was his first year over 60 in a couple of years. Yeah, 2014 was his first year over 60, but 2015 is the first year that he started having Brady-esque numbers. We can't discount Matthew Stafford, he's a future Hall of Famer, and I feel like his card prices are still under value. So 67.2, but just look at these comparisons. Brady is Brady. These are insane numbers. Nothing under 60. Nothing. Nothing. But over the last 6 years, 7 years, Matthew Stafford has been on a tear. So is the prime age for a quarterback really? Like, how old is he? The prime age for a quarterback really 28 to like 39? How old is Tom Brady now? 42? I don't know. These guys can go for a long while with the rules that are in place. But I'm a hater. I'm a hater, but it's okay. I brought this man's stats up because I'm a salty 49er fan. And I just feel like I see why people, like I said, Matthew Stafford, it took him what, 8 years to get another 5,000 yard performance, but that's still insane. But this is the true test. No time to kill. I'm interested on what happens with him because 62, 66, 65, 66, these being the first year, not really counting, second year breakout year, crazy. That's insane. If this is above 60 still, then I would say that I'm like, this man is going to be a problem for a while. But if this drops to like 55, 56, then I will continue to hate on this man because of Patrick Mahomes. I despise this man. Patrick Mahomes, straight bullet. The reason why I threw that out there is because this card got bought up, hedged, raw, with a low population. So we're looking at the data for Patrick Mahomes on Market Movers at this current moment in time. This is all the data since the beginning. I would love for there to be a graph and data of the uptick and a graph like this, but an uptick of population. Like every day, a website scrapes the PSA pop report for that card. Check if it goes up, and if it goes up, add a dot, the data point. I wonder what the population is looking back at November 20th, 2019, it being $735. I wonder what the population was back then in PSA 10, and then what it would have increased over this period of time, over these last 3 years. 2.5 years. Okay, now we're looking at them compared to each other. Patrick Mahomes and Josh Allen. The population on this app just needs to be here. The population on this parts needs to be shown. Because Josh Allen is such a low population compared to Mahomes. And Patrick Mahomes was the person that everyone wanted. People still want him, but the person that has created the most value has in football over the last, when did his prices go crazy? December of 2020 is when his prices, December 20th to July 18th, the card 5X, the little screen review for that. On December, he sold for 3X. This is how crazy cards can get. December 16th, 2020, sold for 3 grand. December 21st, 2020, Christmas gift, last minute Christmas gift, one day shipping, $1,500. And then over the next couple months, it just all the way up until July, it peaked at $15,500. So while the Patrick Mahomes PSA 10 sat at 5 grand, which at that point, Josh Allen is 3X more expensive than Patrick Mahomes. So if that's true at peak, and it's kind of like this, that would mean that if it was at that ratio, at 3X, that means that as Josh Allen increases, or let's just say it stays right, it's been very flat, they're all bottom right now. But if it's a ratio of 3X, Josh Allen needs to be 3X of what it is, then Josh or Patrick Mahomes needs to be less still, because 3X is very important. That's 12K. And that means Patrick Mahomes is going down more. So that's just my little rant. So hopefully you enjoyed that video. I hope you and your family are safe and healthy. Take care. Bye.
Just a disclaimer, I am not responsible for your financial decisions. Do what you want to do. Don't blame me, because it's not my fault. I'm not financially liable for the decisions that you make based on this video. Thank you very much. Have a great day.